वचनम दृक् तदृश्यं दृक्तु मानसम्। दृश्याभिवृत्तयः साक्षी दृगो वनतु दृश्यते। नीलपीतस्थूल सूक्ष्म ह्रस्व दीर्घादिभेदतः नानाविधानि रूपाणि अश्योल्लोचनमेकधा। With an intention to reveal the true nature of the individual, Vidyaranya has started the inquiry in the form of Drik Drishya Viveka. Approach to the inquiry is in this fashion: whatever is drishyam is different from me. Is an object of my perception. I am the perceiver, Drik only. And for this purpose, he has made a graded statement, that is, Rupam Drishyam Lochanam Drik. From the standpoint of the external world, the sense organs are the perceivers, the subject, and the external world is an object. And even though the sense organs are the subjects with respect to the external world, the very sense organs become the objects with respect to the mind. Which means, sense organs are not the absolute subjects, they are only relative subject, relative perceivers. It is not the absolute perceiver. And with respect to the sense organs, mind becomes the perceiver. But we find that the mind also is a perceiver with respect to the sense organs only. But we find the mind also becomes perceivable to me when I am aware of the mind and its conditions and its function, which we call as dhivrittayaha. Vritti means functions, conditions. Therefore, the mind also is not the absolute perceiver. It is a perceiver with respect to sense organs. Indriya apekshaya manaha drik, tasmat manasaha driktvam apekshikam. अपेक्षितत्वात् अपेक्षितम्। एंड व्हेन द माइंड इटसेल्फ इज अ परसीव्ड ऑब्जेक्ट दृश्यम्, हु इज द परसीवर दृक्, आई द कॉन्शियस प्रिंसिपल, द अवेयरनेस प्रिंसिपल, which he calls as Sakshi, the witness. So the witness awareness, the witness consciousness is the perceiver with respect to the mind. So therefore he made three statements. World is perceived, sense organs are perceiver. Sense organs are perceived, mind is perceiver, mind is perceived, witness consciousness is perceiver. Sanskrit use pannaamiye solli paakren. Mind is perceived, witness consciousness is perceiver. Witness consciousness is perceived. Chalandiya. Witness consciousness is ever the perceiver, never the perceived. And therefore we can say witness consciousness is unconditional perceiver, nirapeksha drik. Baki illadella sapeksha drik. आपेक्षिक दृक्। सो देयरफॉर ऑल अदर्स आर दृक्स समटाइम एंड दे बिकम दृश्यम फ्रॉम अनदर एंगल, जस्ट लाइक अ पर्सन बीइंग अ फादर। Fatherhood is not the absolute status of the person. He is father from the standpoint of his son, but he himself becomes son from the standpoint of his father. If he is an absolute father, what will happen? He must be father to everyone, including his parents, including his brother, including his wife. Life itself will be impossible. So therefore, unconditional fatherhood is possible only for one, the Father in heaven. That means the Lord. So therefore, what do you mean by relative perceiver and absolute perceiver? Perceiver at some time, at the same time perceived at another time. Whereas absolute perceiver is always perceiver. That's why he said, "Drigeva na tu drishyate." Now, having made this concise statement in the first shloka, the author is now taking up each aspect of the first shloka. And what was the first statement? World is the perceived, sense organs are the perceiver. That he explained in the second shloka. Nila bhuta sthula sukshma harasva dirghadi bhedatah. So we find that the drishyam, the objects, are many, the druk is one. Colors are many, I is one. And not only that, colors vary, change, but the I does not change. when the color changes from blue to red, I, that is the EYE, I can have a confusion in there. So therefore the chakshu does not change from blue to red. And therefore we get the 2 points. Drishyams are nana and vikaram. Nana vidam. Many and changing. Whereas drik is one and not changing. And therefore he said, nana vidani rupani. பஷ்யேத் லோசனம் என்னதான் லோசனம் ஏகவதனத்தில் போட்டார் லோசனம் ஏகம் அந்த ரூபாணி பகுவதனம் இந்த லோசனம் ஏகவதனம் அந்த நானா விதானி இங்க ஏகதா அப் டு தட் வி சா இன் தி லாஸ்ட் கிளாஸ் நவ் வி வில் கண்டினியூ ஆந்தியமாந்தியபடுத்வேஷு நேத்ரதர்மேஷு தைகதா சங்கல்பயோன்மனிஸ்ரோத்ர வகாபௌயோஜ்யத்தாமிதம் Now in this shloka, the second quarter of the first shloka is explained. The first shloka has 4 quarters. Each quarter is explained by one shloka. The first quarter of the first shloka is explained in the second shloka. The second quarter of the first shloka is explained in the third shloka. What is the second quarter of the first shloka? Eyes are perceived, mind is perceiver. World is perceived, eyes are perceiver, is over now. Now we have come to the next interior step. Eyes are perceived, mind is perceiver. Lochanam drishyam manaha drik. That is explained here. Andhya mandhya Patutveshu. The eye has got various condition. What are the conditions? Patutvam. அது முதல்ல எடுத்துக்கலாம். ஆந்திரத்தில் ஆரம்பிக்க வேண்டாம். Patutvam means very powerful eye. கழுத மாதிரி இருக்கான் கண்ணு சொல்லாலும் has got a powerful vision. Similarly, the eyes can be powerful. That is called patutvam. Patu means powerful, skilled, smart, efficient. Okay, efficient is better. So efficiency of the eyes, which means specs are not necessary. அப்படி வச்சுக்கிறோமே கண்ணாடி போட்டுக்காதவா. Then what is the next stage? கண்ணாடி போட்டுருக்கிறவா. Which seems to be majority nowadays. So therefore, that is called மாந்தியம். மாந்தியம் means what? Not fully efficient. Dull. Weak, less efficient. தமிழ்ல சொல்ற மந்தம் தான். மந்தஸ்ய பாவஹா மாந்தியம், பட்டோஹோ பாவஹா பட்டுத்வம். பாட்டியம் சொல்லக்கூடாது, பட்டுத்வம்.
मंदस्य भावः मांद्यम
वीकनेस दैट इज विशेष प्रकाशः नास्ति The eye does not have the subtle power to distinguish. It has got only samanya prakasham. Kannadu potukalayana, I have got only a hazy, common samanya prakasham. If I put the specs, it becomes patuhu. Without that, it is mandaha. Aro varamadrikan theriyadhu, aari theriyale sollalaya. That is mandyam. Then there is a third category, enna kannadi potalum poyadum illai. So even if you put the specs, it is useless. It is called andhyam. Andhyam enadum andhasya bhavaha andhyam, blindness, total blindness. So thus efficiency of the eyes, weakness of the eyes, and what you call the blindness of the eyes, these are the three stages possible for the eyes, which is known to me or not. Certainly these conditions are known, therefore eyes and their conditions have become now drishyam. You should not take seen. Eyes are not seen, but known. In the drishyam shana, you have to take in the general sense, it is recognized, known, aware, noticed. Okay, netra dharmeshu. Then such conditions of the eyes are there. Manaha sankalpayet. The mind awareness recognizes the conditions of the eyes, which means the mind has become now drifting. Sankalpayet chulitana pashyet anada artham. மனசினோடு டெபனிஷன் சங்கல்ப விகல்பாத்மகங்கிறதுக்காக சங்கல்ப ஏத் போட்டிருக்கார். ஹியர் சங்கல்ப ஏத் மீன்ஸ் பஷ்யேத், ஜானியாத், அவகச்சேத். ஓகே, அண்ட் ஹவு டஸ் தி மைண்ட் ரெக்கக்னைஸ்? ஏ கதா, மைண்ட் இஸ் ஒன். And not only that, mind does not go through patutvam, mandyam, etc. when the eyes are changing from patutvam to mandyam. So when the efficiency of the sense organs vary, along with these variations, mind also does not vary. Can you get the point? When the eye is patu, and patu means efficient, okay, I don't say that the mind is efficient. And when the eye is gradually becoming weak, mind also becomes weak, I don't say. And when the eyes have become completely defunct, non-functional, it is not that mind also becomes non-functional. That means eyes go through variations, but mind does not vary with the eyes. Therefore, ekadha, ekam and ekavidham. Sense organs are many and many vidham. Nana and nana vidham. So, sankhya bhedaha vartate. प्रकार भेदश्च वर्तते मनसि संख्या प्रकार भेदौ न स्तः. ओके, एंड नाउ ही सेज हियर वी हैव टेकन आईज एज ए सैंपल ओनली. दिस हैज टू बी एक्सटेंडेड टू
all other sense organs also. Similarly, ears also have got three avasthas. Patu, Nanna Kadrdo Sadanadi. Therefore, the secret talked on the eighth house, especially if it is a secret. This person can hear very powerful ears. Dog's ear. Like vulture's eye, dog's ear. That is called patutvam. And thereafter, the next stage is mandyam. It is not that powerful. Kitta ganda kirkum, ilina apri pochinda kirkum, ilina hearing aid ochinda kirkum. Mandyam. And then what is the final one? Stone deaf sonoradhyam. That is the third. Similarly, in the tongue, generally tongue will have the that is, that seems to be efficient till death. So therefore, maybe possible, we don't know, scientists alone should say, whether in tongue also there is a difference. Therefore, he says, shrotratvagadav. So you should extend this rule to other sense organs also. That is ears, nose, tongue and skin. Yojyatam idam. Idam means what? That they are many and varied. Mind is one without variation. With this, the second quarter has been explained. Now the third quarter of the first shloka is to be explained in the fourth shloka. Kamasankalpasandehau Shraddha Shraddhe Dhritare Khrir Dhir Bhiritteva Madin Dhir Bhiritteva Bhasayatye Kadhachitihi. Now what is the third quarter of the first shloka? The mind is a perceived object. Witness consciousness is the perceiver. So we have crossed three stages. World is perceived, sense organs are perceiver, passed. Then sense organs are perceived, mind is perceiver, has been covered. Now we are discussing mind is drishyam, perceived, witness consciousness is perceiver. And what do you mean by the mind being perceived? Vidyaranya says, that the various conditions of the mind are known to me. Dhi vrittayaha, dhi avasthaha, dhi vikaraha. So the conditions of the mind, the functions of the mind, the modifications of the mind, they are all known to me. Not only that, each avastha, each condition of the mind is even clearly labeled by me, tagged by me. What are they? He gives a sample list. Kamaha. So when the mind is in a particular condition, we call it desire. When you say, I have a desire, that desire is the condition of what? It is not the condition of the body, but it is the condition of the mind only. therefore kamah desire, which we will discuss elaborately tomorrow. Kama yesha krodha yesha varvardhan. Then sankalpaha. Sankalpaha means what? Sankalpaha, you know, sankalpaha is a resolve. A resolve that tomorrow I will do that. It also means fancy. In the Gita, sankalpa is said to be a stage before kama. A vague desire is sankalpa, and the very desire strengthened is said to be kama. Sankalpa prabhavan kaman. Right. So we can take sankalpaha as a resolve. When do we take the meaning as resolve? When we do rituals, we say mamopata samastha durudakshaya dvara idam karma karishye. Ange enartham, I am taking a resolve that I will do this karma. But in the context of Gita, sankalpa is used in the sense of kamaha in bud form. Budding kama is sankalpa, fully blossomed sankalpa is kamaha. Atarana, two avastha. Sankalpaha, then sandehaha. Sandeham nartham dhrimalyo. Sandehamindiye. Sandehaha, right. Sandehaha, doubt. Then Shraddha, that also we know, faith. Ashraddha, the absence of it, or the opposite of it. Ashraddhe, Dvivachanam. So Shraddha cha, Dvandva samasa. Shraddha cha, Ashraddha cha, Shraddha, Shraddhe. Then Dhritihi. So in the books here, Ramakrishna Mission books, there is a correction about Bhuti Podrika. It should be Dhriti. So ippudi irukkaradhu ippudi maatanam. So Dhritihi. Dhritihi means determination. Dhritihi, willpower, determination. Then Itare. Itaraha means the opposite of dhritihi, adhritihi. Dhriti and the other one. Other one na adhritihi. Here also dvandva samasa. For fancy students, dhritishcha itaracha dhrititare. Akaranta strilingyaha dhrititara shabdaha prathama divachanam. So dhrititare. Then Hrihi. Hrihi means modesty. It also means shyness. Modesty in the positive sense, shyness in the negative sense. Hrihi lajja. Then Dhihi. Dhihi means jnanam, knowledge.